What's up, everybody? This is Carolina Mike, your host for SharePoint in 60 seconds, where you can get the information you need in the first 60 seconds, and you can stick around for a step-by-step run-through. Today, we're going to learn what's the difference between moving and copying a file in SharePoint Online. Stick around. I'm a SharePoint expert, play with data extra. Careful with my hands, because I got to use them for work. Yeah, I'm a big old nerd. I like maple syrup. All my pancakes, I don't care what you heard. Okay, so before we get started, please like, please subscribe, and share with someone if you think they can find value. Thank you so much for your support. We appreciate you. Here we go. 60 seconds. Difference between moving and copying in SharePoint. Move is going to take the file in all of its versions, remove it from the current location, and place it in a new document library. All the versioning intact, all that jazz. Copy leaves the original version alone and burns a copy of that as a brand new version wherever you're going to dump it. You do not get your versioning. Keep that in mind. That's the difference. Pretty sure that was in under 60 seconds. All right, now let's get on to a demo of how we can actually do that in real life. Check it out. So we're going to grab a few files here, and we have another document library in this particular site that we are going to move these files to. So we'll move these files, and we're going to go to move to, and it's going to ask us or immediately put us on the current library. If I wanted to move them within this library, maybe to a new folder within this library, I could do that, or to OneDrive or to other sites. Okay, now I should also be able to select from, this is my current site here, Customer Demo Hub. So if I select that site, it will show me all the other document libraries. And I could choose this library again, or I could choose a different library. And so we're going to choose Use Folders Wisely. And one thing I want to call your attention to, all right, let's back up a step here. Let's go here. So this graphic represents an entire document library. So this is an entire container of files. When I select a document library, let's say I'm going to move these into Use Folders Wisely, I'm presented with another set of yellow folders, but these do not represent entire document libraries. They represent folders within the document library that you just selected, which is called Use Folders Wisely. I find it a bit confusing. I'm trying to see if there's any difference between the icons here, but I don't really see a difference. And I would love, Microsoft, if you're watching, please give us a different icon, but maybe I'm just being too particular. All right, so we're going to choose the destination, Use Folders Wisely. So we could dump it into an existing folder. If we want to, we have to click on that folder. Now it's highlighting Funk as a folder, but it is not, see, we're not in that folder. See, I had to click on it. So if I go back here, if I click Funk, then I'm putting it in Funk, or I could build a new folder inside Funk. So this, you know, if you choose to move here, please know that you will not be putting these files inside Funk. They will be alongside Funk. So they'll be listed as separate items, not inside this folder. You've got to click on it. So then, or you could create a new folder here if you so desire. So we're going to click on Move Here, and something's going to happen here. It actually moved them. I was expecting that was going to throw an error. There was metadata that existed here that did not exist in the new location. So we're going to see how that all played out on the other side. But you can see the files are moved. So let's go take a peek in the other doc library. So we'll go to Site Contents, and we'll visit Use Folders Wisely. And there are files, just like I said, they're not inside Funk. Very interesting. I've seen it throw an error before, because I don't believe I have size. Maybe it's copy that will do that. So, all right. So we saw the example here. Let's go to copy and see if we can get it to throw the error that I'm talking about. We're going to do just one file this time, and we'll copy it. Now in this instance, we aren't going to see any versioning. We'll go to the Demo Hub, we'll go to Use Folders Wisely, and we will copy here. Huh. Well then let me go over here and check the library settings to see if we actually have, we don't have columns for that. Very interesting. This library does not have the size and color info that these files would have. And I moved and copied, and it didn't throw the error. I know I've seen it. So if you've seen that error in the in here before, comment below. Now I am on targeted release, so it's possible that they're, you know, working on that in the background. So, well, there you go. That is a quick and easy way to move files between document libraries. Now, the cool thing about this is you can pick any site, any document library in your tenant, any of them. If for some reason you go and you try to use this move and you don't see a site, you can go to Browse Sites, and that will show you the sites that you're following. So that's one way you can make sure you have access, is if it doesn't show up, then go follow that site. And how do you follow the site? Well, at the top, there's going to be a little star. Just click on following. So there's your bonus tip. With that, I'm going to say, stay positive. Do the best you can with what you got. Please like, subscribe, and share. Thank you for your support. We'll see you on the next video. Remember, SharePoint rocks. And so do you. Take it easy, y'all. I'm a SharePoint expert. Play with data extra. Careful with my hands, because I got a